crafty friends. Kim Kesty here, and I am introducing a What's New at Spellbinders, and I'm very pleased today to be talking about Becca Feakin's new collection. It is called Pico Petite, and it is so amazing. Just take a look. First of all, we've got six different items in this release. Let's talk about the first four. These are kind of what I call in my mind instant classics. Becca has done all of our basic shapes, square, oval, circle, and rectangle, in this beautiful pico pattern. Now, those of you who are not familiar with the word pico, maybe you don't know where it comes from. Well, Becca, of course, is known for all love of things vintage and antique-y, and this is actually an old-time sewing technique, in particular a lace technique. The original seamstress who would create this pattern would take twisted loops of thread and create these beautiful patterns, typically on the edge of a fabric. You can see that it's got that beautiful loop detail. So classic Becca, we know that these are absolutely going to be gorgeous for all of your projects. Let's take a look at a few samples before we flip over to the other two. Here's just a beautiful little card just made with the classic squares. In this card, we've layered up two layers of squares, kind of that pretty gold underneath, if you can peek at that. And then any color solid cardstock on top, and you have a simple but absolutely stunning little card. So that's a small square. Of course, the squares come in three different sizes. You're going to have all sorts of possibilities there. Next, we have the oval. Absolutely stunning. I think the oval really reflects kind of the idea of the lace and the pattern. So absolutely love this one. Layered it up with one of Becca's stamp and die combos, which is just perfect. So awesome. Here we have the circle next. So again, we've got that wonderful detail. And I don't know if you can see, but you can see that we have the inside cut lines. So all of these patterns can be cut with the circle out of the middle, like we did for this one, or you can keep the die cut solid. So definitely lots of flexibility here. And last but not least, we have the beautiful rectangle. And again, you can see, and this one's a better example of how we can cut the inside of that rectangle out. So you see, we just have created the frame look here, whereas this die back here is the solid. So again, lots of flexibility. So love those four basics. You're going to see them showing up in some of the other samples as we go along. But let's take a look at the two coordinating dies that go with this collection. Let's look at the square first. This filigree quartet is absolutely stunning. And those of you who remember, she had a circular, similar die, of course, different pattern, when she released her dimensional doily collection. So this is a square version, super fun. And similar to the other die, all of these pieces can be inset. They can be cut separately. They can be cut with the outlines, just so many possibilities. And even this cute little piece inside, it's a little photo corner. So perfect for adding a little note or adding a photo to your project. Let's take a look at this guy. Let's look at this one first. This has actually got the die, the four pieces of the die inlaid in just a larger piece of cardstock. Isn't that gorgeous? Wouldn't that be beautiful popped up also? Give you a little bit extra dimension behind the pattern. So awesome. And then this guy, we've actually cut out the outside of the frame. So again, layering it up with that square Pico Petite absolutely gives you those beautiful layers on your card project. So lots of great flexibility with the filigree quartet. And last but not least, this fancy looking thing, so cute, it's called Bed of Lace. So of course goes along with her theme of the Pico Petite. So not only do we have this beautiful die, which is her split rim technology, which means you can use the rims with or without. These are actually two separate dies, so you can arrange them in any pattern that you want. And then of course, it's awesome to have these sweet little labels. These are gonna be perfect with any of Becca's stamped or glimmered sentiments. You're gonna have a great time layering all of those together. But let's take a look at this guy. Here's a beautiful project where we've actually cut out the outside of the frame and layer it up with a solid cardstock behind. Makes that beautiful, beautiful pattern. And then here's a kind of different, unique way to use it. So again, because it has that split rim, you don't have to cut the frame out. So we've just layered up the die in all four corners and then created this beautiful kind of shadow effect where you can see the inside of the card peeking through. So fun, right? So many possibilities. So again, six brand new products in Becca Feakin's Pico Petite collection. Coming soon to Spellbinders, as always, you can check out our website, and I know that you'll have an amazing time creating with these beautiful new dies.